My name is Gabriel Clarke. I'm the writer-director of Steve McQueen, The Man and Le Mans. The documentary is essentially the story of Steve McQueen and his making of the film Le Mans. It's the story of how Steve, at that time, was obsessed to make the ultimate racing film. And it's the story of how this obsession drove him to the brink in many ways and disrupted the lives, affected the lives of many, but most of all McQueen himself. It's the story of maybe a tragic hero, a man driven to do something which nobody had done before, and how that particular obsession changed his life. The key for us was the fact that this is a great story. It's an untold story in many ways in terms of Steve McQueen, because many people know about his successful career, and yet this film, Le Mans, 1970, he was coming off a huge amount of success at the end of the 60s, notably with Bullet. He was a very rich man. He just started his own production company, which had made an awful lot of money out of Bullet. He was at the top of his time, and he could make the ultimate racing film. And it was this particular obsession that he had, which, as I say, affected him in so many ways. And it's the fascination of this story that drove us to make this film. Also, there's an incredible amount of unseen archive from this particular time, which was something we'd been told about, something that we wanted to research and find. And luckily enough, we managed to find a great deal of it, including the rushes from the original filming, hundreds of feet of film, an awful lot more than that, actually. Millions of feet of film? A million feet is the rumour. So a million feet of film, which had been shot by McQueen on set. So this was our obsession, to find that film and to see if McQueen indeed had made the ultimate racing film. What makes him unique is his charisma, the way that he looked, the way that he understood cinema. He was a man very much of looks and glances more than words, which made him unique. And that's why he was so successful on screen. He knew the value of a glance or a look or a smolder. He was able to do that. What I hope people take away from this film is the fact that even if you are a Steve McQueen fan, even if you're a motor racing fan, you take away from this the untold story, the story in a way that McQueen was at this point in his life becoming a tragic figure because he had this obsession to make the ultimate racing movie, because it then ruined his marriage, it destroyed his company, he took the film to the brink, it destroyed long-lasting relationships he'd had with business partners, with directors, the director who made him, John Sturges. It changed people's lives who worked on that film. So I think you cannot help but be fascinated by the man, but also at this particular point, you cannot help, when you watch this film, I think, to be fascinated by what the man was capable of and how much he damaged, all in the name of this one obsession.